Hey guys, welcome. This is the start of the 36 Lacrosse / Ted Spirides blog, or video blog, I guess. Just something that I've kind of wrestled with for about a year now, trying to get more content out there. I get a lot of questions from coaches, from players on little things that sometimes it's hard to respond to everybody and to, get answers to everybody. So I thought this could be a cool way for me to share just a lot of information each week with you. So this whole vlog thing, actually, I got to give a shout out to my friend Mike Vacanti, and I'm gonna link him up here in the video. So Mike and I both went to high school together. And Mike is actually a year younger than me, so I wouldn't sit here and say that we were best friends or whatever, but we sort of had some mutual friends with we definitely crossed paths. I know I definitely had played him in poker at one of the many big poker tournaments that would go down when the whole World Series of Poker thing was blowing up when I was in high school. But anyway, he started his own business doing training, like physical training, exercise training, lifting, nutrition, that sort of thing. And he's doing a really great job and he knows his stuff. And lately he's been doing a lot more blogging and writing and content creation and really putting a ton of great stuff out there that I thought was super cool and kind of inspired me to go ahead and get started doing it too. So I got to give a shout out to him. He definitely, motivated me through just his own action of going out and doing it. So hopefully this adds some value to you guys. And first thing we're going to talk about today, I actually recently have gotten like 5 emails from different people, different coaches, all have had kids in the 36 Lacrosse program that have asked me about overhand shooting and how a lot of their kids are, we grow up playing hockey here in Minnesota, so everybody just kind of drops their hands and shoots that underhand sidearm shot, and they try to teach overhand shooting, but they just can't seem to find a way to connect the what they're supposed to do with getting the kids to do it. And I found just through training here the last year or so, I've figured out a really cool and easy way to get kids to start shooting that overhand release. So we're going to go back in the training center and hope you guys like it. Hey guys, I want to talk about some overhand shooting techniques that we use here at 36 Lacrosse. Something that a lot of coaches have a problem teaching is that overhand motion. It's not that they don't know what the overhand motion is or they're not explaining it right, but what the player is feeling is different than what the coach is saying. So they could say shoot overhand or paint the pipe or extend your arms, anything like that. But the player may think that they're actually doing that and they're actually still just dropping their hands. And I'm not 100% like against sidearm shots or underhand shots or whatever, but you need to be able to do everything, and it starts with a good overhand motion. Overhand shots are the highest percentage shot you can take. So teaching them a good overhand release and getting that down, then they can start to build sidearm shots, underhand shots, different release points as they get better. The reason I have a helmet here is just I found this to be a great way to get them to feel and visualize what an overhand shot is, and what they're visualizing and doing is actually translating to what's happening in their body. So generally a lacrosse helmet has these vents. A lot of kids that are playing on teams or whatever even have decals. If they don't have decals, just tell them to, just describe it as the vents. So they have these vents on top of their helmet. So what we like to say is when you're following through, make sure the head of the stick comes over the vents on your helmet. So they are going to bring now the head of the stick and they're going to come straight over the vents on their helmet. And it might be over, it might feel like they're over exaggerating it a little bit, all right? Which is okay, especially in practice, because chances are they're going to start to revert back a little bit more to sidearm and they're going to be right here
for an overhand shot, but they can, they know where the vent is on their helmet, they know where their stick head is, and they can visualize and feel with their body an overhand shot, bring the head of the stick over the vent of their helmet. So basically now what we want to do is it should start to look like this. They get their hands back, they step into their shot, and they're coming straight over there at those vents on their helmet. And they're going to start to feel this and shoot that overhand release. And this is a good way for them to start doing that motion over and over again. They can consistently do it every single time. And once they can consistently do it every single time, then they'll be able to sort of self-correct, and they're going to feel themselves the next time they do a sidearm shot, and they're here, and they drop and go sidearm, and it goes 30 yards wide, they're going to feel that motion, and then you can say, hey, what, was that overhand? And they're going to go, no, I didn't go over the vents on my helmet, I dropped my hands, and that self-correction is now what allows a shooter to become an elite shooter, because you're always going to make mistakes, you're always going to make bad shots, but you know that's what separates like a pro golfer from an amateur golfer, is they can hit a bad shot and go, oh, I know where my hands were there, that's why that happened, and then the next time they're correcting it and doing it the